Hello everyone and welcome to War Party. War Party is an upcoming real-time strategy game that is set in the Stone Age, or rather an artist's interpretation of the Stone Age. This is the usual like pop culture Stone Age where you have surprisingly modern technology, a little bit of magic as well as dinosaurs and whatnot. We are playing as this tribe here. So the game is mostly your standard real-time strategy game with base building. You've got workers who gather resources and stuff. In this case we have food and we have these green crystals here, which may or may not be Tiberium. And you build buildings to houses, in this case to increase your population cap. You build barracks to train your warriors. You've got one hero unit here. It's Mika in our case. She is our Stone Age warrior woman, and she's tall. Look how tall he is compared to one of the regular workers here. She's something like 11 foot tall. That said, let's start to get some more villagers, and then let's start expanding our village here. You have the usual selection of buildings, what you would expect. The settlement here is our headquarters that trains more workers, and we have reached our maximum population, so let's build one of these houses here to increase our pop cap. And we also have this watchtower here, that's your standard base defense. And while we're at it, and while we are sorting out our stuff here, let's explore a little bit. And there we go, we've got our hut. In this case, we should probably get another farm. Yeah, you have to find crystals on the map, but you can build farms. And you can put three guys into each farm. So if you have a couple of those, you pretty much have enough food for the rest of the game. We also have dinosaurs here. Let's see whether Mika can take on this guy here by herself. Ooh, I don't think she can. Ah, let's maybe not do this then. Let's come back. And let's put a couple more guys into this farm here, and then more resources are required. That's okay. Is the dinosaur following me? Nope, doesn't look like it. That's fine. There are a couple of different abilities you can select before a match starts. So this is the better version of the game, so there are no campaign missions yet, but you can play skirmish against the AI or against other humans on three different maps. We start with a snow map here, which is just a one versus one map. And you can choose different abilities in the beginning. There's one that makes your workers cheaper and makes them work faster, which is the one I choose. There's one that gives you necromancy, that allows you to get zombies. We're going to definitely try that one out. There's also one that allows you to train certain units. I think either your standard melee unit or your standard range unit directly from your settlement, so you can get started pretty quickly. And all kinds of fancy things. For now, I think I want one more farm, just so we can speed up our food production a little bit more. You can help raising that. And the next guy can do that as well. And then I can maybe save one guy to either build stuff or collect more crystals or whatnot. So there we go. That should give us some good food income. There's also a fourth resource, power. So power is essentially your magic or special meter. You can take over these sacred sites here and get power through that. You can also get it through this Gwon extractor, but to get that you need power first. Okay, but what we want before we get started with that is probably storage hut, maybe. Well, let's build a tower here, just so we have towers on both sides of our village. And then we can maybe build a barracks and get some warriors started. So we can hunt some dinosaurs. Dinosaurs can give you food, and they will also guard these holy sites here, so we want to take out a couple of those. They thrive quite well in the snowy environment here. But some of them actually have feathers, so that's kind of a nice touch, because I'm not quite sure how much you follow dinosaur news, but the very lizard-like dinosaurs, which is the way they're generally depicted in pop culture, that may not be quite as accurate as we once thought it was, and they might have been a lot more bird-like than we initially assumed, even though dinosaur's a bit of a wishy-washy term anyway, because there's a ton of dinosaurs that lived at different times, and I think the modern birds are still dinosaurs from like a taxonomical point of view, but don't quote me on that, I'm not an expert on that. Anyway, what we also want is probably another hut, and let's build that here. We also have some snowmen here. Yeah, this game seems to be quite charming, the artwork is quite nice, and we do have We do have a nice selection of like cute looking buildings here as well. My first impression is that the game looks fairly standard with regard to like what you can select. You have in your barracks here, you have your standard melee unit, an axe guy, and you have hunters here, your archers in this case, your standard range unit. But to be honest, it's fine. I like games like that. And there haven't really been that many in recent times that go back to the like very like stand formula for that. So I don't mean that as a negative necessarily. And if it's a fun and charming game, then I'm happy with that. I think I also want maybe a medic's hut so we can get some healers. And they have a healing aura, that always sounds good. That will save us trouble later, hopefully. And maybe even get one more farm or so, because we don't seem to have too much food. Because all the buildings cost food as well. It's not just your units that require food. Yeah, let's get another couple of workers and then let's maybe get you to build me another farm. Also like this medicine hut here, that we've got this kettle full of, I don't know, a cauldron full of, I don't know what that is. Maybe it's blood. Maybe it's dinosaur, sweet delicious dinosaur blood. Who knows? In any case, you please come over here. And you build me that, and once we have a couple more guys in our titular war party, we can move out and slay some dinosaurs, and then ultimately also destroy our enemies, the orange tribe, because there's only space for one tribe on this map here. So let's see, how expensive are you? 50 food, that's not terribly expensive actually, and we still have some pop points left, so let's get a couple of you once we can afford that. And what were you doing there? When did I build you? Never mind. You know what? Maybe I should get at least one more hut first, then I probably have enough pop to last me until I've raised my entire army here. There we go. I think overall the game is quite neatly designed. We do have all these symbols here. Everything's quite intuitive, of course. If you are generally a fan of real-time strategy, then this game here isn't holding too many surprises as of now, but it does have a couple of nice additions that are in other games as well, but are generally welcome. You do have this power meter here, but we'll get to that in a bit. For now, let's get up here and let's slay that Tyrannosaur, Allosaur. Not an expert, I'm not quite sure how accurate this game's dinosaurs are, and I only care so much, to be honest. But we'll see. In any case, let's jump to you. And the crystal's running low on resources. That's okay, because we are going to get more crystals soon. Okay, so the end is nigh for you. There we go. So let's just stay here and heal up a little bit. And let's hope... we might lose a warrior or two here, but that's fine. We can replace those guys quite easily. And as long as we have two healers here, this shouldn't be too much of a problem. Look how this dinosaur looks like. It's really sweet, and it turns into sweet delicious meat. So let's collect that meat. We don't really have too many guys here, so we should probably go back home and gather a couple more. We do, for example, have these archers here. Those look quite nice. They look a little bit like lizard people, but that's because they have this tail, this facial mask. I think it's just supposed to be, it's obviously not fur, but it's kind of the bearskin equivalent to a slain dinosaur, which is quite nice. So where are my healers? Oh yeah, I left you up there. Sorry, didn't do that on purpose. We have a ton of food now, so we should probably build a ton of units. Also, did I have any space left for maybe another house here? Yep, now that those crystals are gone, that shouldn't be a problem. And after that, you can actually get up here and build me a storage hut here. Yeah, that looks good. Then you can get me crystals there in a bit. So we've got two healers here. And I think our army is strong enough to at least move out and slay some more dinosaurs. So it shouldn't be too much of a problem. And now that you've built that, let's actually... Yeah, I think we have enough. You can collect more crystals here. And then we can expand a little bit in the future. Can I go through here? I guess I can, but why not capture this one here first? There we go. This Triceratops seems to be a lot weaker than the not T-Rex we fought earlier, whatever kind of dinosaur that was supposed to be. There, yeah, this is a lot easier. But I think the Triceratops was an herbivore. Don't quote me on that. My dinosaur knowledge is a bit out of date, potentially. In any case, so here we have this holy site here, guarded by more dinosaurs. Cold-resistant dinosaurs. But that's not a problem for us. Yeah, we should be able to do this with pretty much no losses. Also, it looks like our healers are carrying around the soup here. Nice. I guess it's just delicious soup that keeps us healthy. So you must die as well. You don't seem to be very much interested in helping your friend. I'm not quite sure whether these are supposed to be feathers or like fins or scales or whatever, but it looks kind of neat. I like the style. There we go. So now we have captured the shrine. And we're running low on crystals, but that's fine because we have more crystals up here. And did we... Yeah, we did get more warriors, so I may as well add you to the party. In fact, all of you... So you can come over here. And after that... You know what? Let's just continue to build, guys. And here we go. More ranged units because I like those. Oh, and Orange is coming for us. Oh dear. That's a strong party. But maybe we can slay the hero at least. Ooh, that might be a little bit more than I can chew right now. But we do have reinforcements coming in. So there's a chance that we will do this. And our hero is going to come out on top here. Oh, and they have zombies. So that makes them definitely more evil. Okay, let's slay you. And they have... Wow, are they just raising those again? I guess they are. Okay, let's go into the archers. And let's war party you. There we go, but we probably want some melee guys back because I have a lot of healers. I should probably get a couple more of those as well. Yeah, let's get like 4 or 5 healers. There we go. And then let's slay the rest of their guys here. Yeah, we will definitely going to come out on top of this. They may... Oh, they only have healers left, which, if I remember correctly, can't actually attack by themselves. They can heal one another, obviously, but that's only a delaying tactic, so that you're not going to survive that. Okay, that's actually pretty good. That means they should be a bit weakened now as well, because... where did you come from? I thought I lost both of you. Never mind. Let's get up here and let's get a... Yeah, let's wait until a couple more guys come up here. Let's get... Oh, so this is their holy site. Well, now it's mine. There we go. There we go indeed. And... Oh, wait, you're capturing shrine. So I guess we have to stay here for a while. Yeah, that makes sense. Well, that makes sense. That's how it works in video games. That's what I mean by that makes sense. Okay, there we go. And since we're at it, I guess you guys can quickly build me another barracks. Just to speed things up a little bit. And since I have the building speed bonus, it shouldn't take too long. And then we can spam guys even harder. So reinforcements are on their way. That's great. And there we go. So a couple more melee guys, because I lost a lot of those, and more of you. And we're going to run low on pop soon as well, but I think that's okay, because this should be... Then again, if we attack them on their home turf, maybe that's not enough to destroy them, but we'll see. Let's capture that last shrine first, and then we'll see whether or not we can deal with the rest they have here. Probably should send you guys crystal harvesting. There we go. And then let's jump to back to you and slay some more dinosaurs. Your various powers here. Thunder, that's a direct damage attack. This here lifts the fog. We can actually do that just to see how well they're doing. Well, I guess they still have the village, and we've got the war cry that powers our units up. So capturing shrine. And there we go. Alright, then let's gather here and make our way to their village, and we may as well have you join the war party. There we go. Then let's see whether you have enough power to destroy them all. We'll see about that. I'm playing against the medium AI, so it shouldn't be too difficult, and it's just a 1v1 match. Oh, look at that. Oh, you're building stuff here. What even is that? That's the watchtower. No, thank you. That's one impressive watchtower. Let's destroy that. We should be able to do that before they bring out the rest. Oh, did they just... Wow. Did you just raise a ton of watchtowers in almost no time here. That's a bit scary, but it's okay. There we go. So you please heal my friend here. And the rest of you follow me. And there we go. Okay, so they're now coming for me, sort of. Okay, time to slay them all. And time to get our war cry going. There we go. How expensive is that anyway? 200. Ah, it's not too bad. Okay, they have more base defenses here. That's fine. We can live with that, especially with our nice selection of archers here. And there we go. Then let's just destroy this tower here first, then we can kill the hero. And I think these guys are building more stuff, but that's okay. Okay, there we go. So is that still lasting? I'm not quite sure, but let's just get it going on once more, and then let's kill all of you. Yeah, not a problem for my guys here. There we go. I'm going to burn down your zombies. Even though I'm kind of tempted to try out the zombies myself. And I didn't see there was another watchtower, so let's raise that first. And let's keep everyone healthy. Yeah, it seems I have so much healing at the moment that the AI can't really take me out, because we focus fire too much for that, and they don't focus fire, but that's fine. Also, these snowmen here apparently having some sort of tea party. I'm okay with that. So let's just destroy their farms, and let's destroy their barracks just so they can't get their troops back. And then probably their headquarters. And there we go. That wasn't too much of a problem. Of course, it's just the AI, and I might play against a hard AI later as well, so just to see how that goes. And maybe also in co-op with an AI, but more about that during another match. And boom. Alright, what else do they have left? They have a lot of houses. And I wonder whether those workers up there, whether they would just rebuild the base. I think they will. But we'll see about that. In any case, we will follow them, but we're just going to raise all these houses here because they're pretty brittle anyway, so we may as well finish the job here before we continue. So from what I know, your hero doesn't level up or anything, so it's essentially just a strong unit to start with. And yes, I will accept their surrender. And there we go. I scored higher with regard to military, economy, and also in total, naturally. And yeah, that was War Party. It's a pretty neat game. It doesn't bring too much new to the table, but the setting is actually the real-time strategy Stone Age setting is not completely new. There are some other games like Power World and a couple of older DOS games that have this, but it's not exactly overcrowded. I think it looks actually quite charming, and if they make a good campaign, then I can see this go quite well. It runs fine for me, and it looks quite nice as well. So yeah, keep an eye on this, and I'm definitely going to play a couple more matches to get a closer look at this game here. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.